Hello everyone, today we're going to find out cube root by prime factorization method. So before that, let's understand what is cube and cube root. Cube means when you multiply a given number 3 times, it's called cube. For example, 2 cube. I will multiply 2 3 times, 2 into 2 into 2, which we're going to give us 8. So 8 is a cube of 2. Similarly, if I want to find out 4 cube, so I have to multiply 4 3 times, 4 into 4 into 4, so 4 4s are 16, 16 4s are 64. So 64 is a cube of 4. Now, suppose I want to find out in reverse way, from here to here, means what number I have multiplied 3 times to get 64. So I have to go in reverse way, and that we can find out by using a cube root. So cube root is an inverse operation of cube. And cube and cube root, we can see the both are inverse operation. And it is represented by using the symbol 3 and then root symbols. If you write this, it is square root. If you represent 3 or if you write 3 over here, it becomes cube root. That's it. So don't forget to write a 3 over here. It represents cube root. If you forget about this 3, it's going to become square root. Okay, so here we go. So if I want to find out a cube root of 8, it will be equal to 2 because I have multiplied 2 3 times to get 8. Similarly, if I want to find out cube root of 64, it will be 4 because 4 I have multiplied 3 times to get 64. So this is about a cube root. So 64 and 8 were smaller numbers we could able to find out. But what happens if the numbers are big like this? 1728, so 4 digit number, how to calculate it? So we're going to use a prime factorization method and we're going to solve it. So here we go. Okay, so first you have to take a prime factorization of the given number. So the number is 1728. Now the given number is divisible by 2. It's an even number, so I'll take the first prime number to be 2. Then I'll get, if I divide, 8's are 16, 1 will be left, 6 are 12, and then 4's are 8. Again, it's an even number, I can divide with 2. So 2 4's are 8, 2 3's are 6, 2 2's are 4. Again, it's an even number, so it comes again in 2 table. So 2 2's are 4, 2 1's are 2, then 1 is left, 2 6 are 12. Again, next number. It's again even, so I'm going for 2. 2 1's are 2. But next number is 1. 1 doesn't go in 2 tables. So I'll put 0 and then I'll take 16 together. So 8's are 16. Then next. 2 5's are 10. 2 4's are 8. Then it's again even number. So 2 2's are 4. I'm getting 1 here left. So 7's are 14. Now 27 is a odd number, it doesn't go in 2 tables, so I will go for 3. So next prime number is 3, so 3 9's are 27, and then again I can take 3, 3 3's are 9, and then 3 1's are 3. So this is how we have done prime factorization. The next step is we have to write this given number. So I can write 1728 will be equal to, I will gonna write all the things which I got, that is this. So we have to write all these things which we got while doing a prime factorization. So this will be equal to 2 into 2 into, so I have a 6 2's, so 2 2 2 2, so I have written all the 6 2's, and then I have a 3 3's, so 3 into 3 into 3, that's it. Once you're done with this, the next step is you have to pair in triples. So 3 numbers you should take to form a group. So this will form one group. This is second group. I'm taking a triples here, and this will gonna form one more group. So from each number, you should take one number. So from this group, I'll take 1, 2 multiplied by. From this number, I'll take 1 more 2. And from I'll take 1 more, this 3 I'll get. So cube root of 1, 7, 2, 8 will be 2 into 2 into 3. So 2 2's are 4, 4 3's are 12. So we can say cube root of 1, 7, 2, 8 is equal to 12. Or if you multiply 12 3 times, we'll get 1, 7, 2, 8. This is one example which I have given you. We'll go for one more example. Okay, so this time I'm taking more bigger number, 9, 2, 6, 1. Same thing, do a prime factorization. So you can pause the video here, you can try by yourself, you can again come back to the video and check your answer. So let's do a prime factorization for this number. So 9, 2, 6, 1. If you observe, this number is not even number. I have to, it's odd number. So I will start from 3. So let's check it out if it comes in a 3 table. So 3, 3's are 9. 2 doesn't go. So I'll take 0 here. And I'll take 26 together, which will be 8's are 24. So 2 is my remainder. And 21 will come 7's are. That's it. Then again, it's like an odd number. I'll go for 3. 3 1's are 3, 0 will come directly, 2, 3 2's are 6, so 2 is my remainder, so it will gonna form 27, so 3 9's are 27. Then next again, we'll check for 3 again, 3 3's are 9, I'm taking 10 together, 1 is left, so 3 4's are 12, then 3 3's are 9. And 343 doesn't go in 3 table, so I'm going for next 5, but 343 doesn't come in 5 table. So next prime number will be 7. So 7 4's are 28, so I'll get 6 as a remainder. So 7 9's are 63, so I got 49 now. Then 7 7's are 49, then 7 1's are 7. That's it. Now your next step is write them. So 9 2 6 1 can be written as 3 into 3 into 3 into 7 into 7 into 7. Okay, then once you're written like this, your next step is you have to form a triples. So this forms a one triple and this is one more. So from each you should take one number to get a cube root. So cube root of 9, 2, 6, 1 will be, from this group I'm taking 1, 3 into, from this group I'm taking 1, 7. So that's it, 3 sevens are 21. So therefore, cube root of 9, 2, 6, 1 is 21. So it's very simple. Do the prime factorization method and form a group of 3 numbers. And from each group, take one number and that's going to give you a cube root. So I hope you understood how to do a prime factorization and get the cube root of a given number. So that's it. Thank you so much for watching. Subscribe to my channel and click on bell icon. Thank you.